The Tamron 45mm f1.8 DI VC USD was one of the first large-aperture standard image-stabilized prime lenses offered on the revamped SP Super Performance lineup, featuring Tamron's new Human Touch design scope. Made to compete in the premium low-cost market, introduced by Sigma on its Global Vision lineup, these super performance Tamrons offer new levels of usability, ergonomics, performance, and low cost, all offering a built-in stabilizer based on its legacy with the VC module. At 80 by 91mm of 544 grams of mostly plastic covering metals, the first thing we notice on the Tamron 45mm SP is the size, gigantic compared to any standard f1.8 lens. The Canon's is slightly longer 50mm f1.8. Both Mark II and recent STM are meant as plastic fantastic, easy to use, portable prime lenses that nearly disappear in front of the camera. Not the case with this Tamron. It is big despite being light, featuring the new Human Touch ergonomics. Smooth, large, and with different tactile feedbacks and design, it's a premium feeling you can touch, unheard of at this price point, offering a high-end experience at the f1.8 aperture. The usability is also smooth and straightforward, with a large manual focusing ring paired to large lateral switches, all within hands distance. Inside, Tamron uses its silent USD ultrasonic drive that smoothly moves the all-internal focusing groove with a slightly slow torque curve. It gets faster when it's close to blocking focus, thus not feeling as instant as Canon EF lenses. Nothing does. The minimum focusing distance has also been reduced, offering a near 1x3.4 close-up distance, far from a true macro, but welcomed for everyday life. And also inside, Tamron uses its larger, albeit cheap to implement, excellent VC vibration compensation module. With up to 4 stops of compensation, it brings new possibilities to the standard large aperture spec, and it's indeed one of its strongest selling points. It's more useful than Sigma's f1.4 art lenses, and a great reason to add an all Tamron kit on your backpack. And that's it! At the front, the 67mm filter thread sits well above the first optical element, that itself is coated in fluorine for easy cleaning. At the rear, Tamron declared some level of weather resistance, with a rubber gasket around the mount and rubber pieces around the switches and rings, all suited for extreme photography. And it comes supplied with a lens hood, despite not being used on any of my shots. Overall, this is exactly what we expect from Tamron. Very well put together, easy to use, featuring something extra, here being the VC module. But as we'll see on its images, it's more than capable of delivering good results. Can it be the ultimate large aperture standard prime? Let's take a look. With 10 elements in 8 groups optical formula, sporting one low dispersion piece to keep aberrations low, 2 aspherical pieces to correct for aspherical aberrations, both E-band and B-bar coatings to increase contrast and enhance colors, and a floating focusing system designed to provide excellent image quality no matter the subject distance, what the Tamron 45mm f1.8 SP delivers optically is indeed very good. Not the best like more expensive f1.4 primes, but good enough to excite even the most demanding amateur. It's the good old you get what you paid for situation. The resolution is high on a prime lens, even wide open, is slightly reducing near the frame edges that are improved by spotting down the aperture. By f4 the images are nearly flawless, with reduced vignetting and pin sharp details, perfect for light side prints of landscapes, product photography, street photography and portraits, easy to compete with any higher end prime. The main downfalls are indeed the extra chromatic aberration, here visible on thick green and magenta lines, that are only fixed on much more expensive primes, mainly f1.4 ones. The geometry is also flawless, perfect to shoot straight lines, and so is the good flaring resistance. And even the 9 rounded blade aperture makes a good job at rendering star-shaped highlights when stopped down during long exposures. But it's the bokeh who takes a hit in smoothness from the complicated 10 elements formula, showing signs of repetitive lines, aberration, and even color shifting, begging for a boost in post-processing. So overall, it's a very good performance for a new at the time lineup not as premium as most F1.4s, but not as simple as the F1.8 Plastic Fantastics. So Tamron does have something special on their hands, and it's worth taking a look if you're looking for the next step on your kit. If you're shooting low-light subjects that can benefit from the wide-aperture setting, paired to the good image stabilizer, just add this lens on your kit, and nice shooting.